Good day, dear viewers and listeners. I welcome you all to another episode of our weekly online chemistry class. This is episode 2 of season 9. In the previous episode, we discussed the various types of carbon atoms that exist in organic compounds, starting from the methyl carbon atom down to the benzylic carbon atom. And I told you vividly in that class that the next episode, which is what we are discussing today, will focus on carbonium ions or carbocations and their relative stabilities. We have carbonium ions. A carbonium ion is a carbon atom that is formed when a carbon atom of an organic compound loses hydrogen atom. In a nutshell, a carbonium ion is a carbon atom of an organic compound that contains or that is positively charged. So any carbon atom in organic compound that has positive charge is referred to as a carbonium ion, or you refer to it as a carbocation. Of course, you can see anything that is positively charged is a cation in chemistry, whether organic or inorganic chemistry. Majorly, based on the various types of carbon atoms that we have, those are also the various types of carbonium ions that are likely to exist. Now, in general, carbonium ions can be classified into 3, be it alkyl, allylic, benzylic, or acetylenic. And these 3 types of carbonium ions are primary, we have the primary, secondary, and tertiary carbonium ion. The stability of this carbonium ion depends on some of the factors that were discussed in season 8. And these factors are positive inductive effect, you have the resonance effect, as well as steric effects. And don't forget, in that particular season, I told you that steric effect can be of 2 types, which can be steric acceleration or steric deceleration. Likewise, the inductive effect, which might be positive or negative. Now, we have the first class of carbonium ions. And the first class of carbonium ions are referred to as alkyl carbocations. They are cations or carbocations or carbonium ions obtainable from alkyl groups. And the first of that kind is a methyl carbonium ion. You know, this is a methyl carbon. So because it is positively charged, we now refer to it as a methyl carbonium ion. The second type of alkyl carbonium ion is a primary carbonium ion. And what makes it primary? Because it has 2 replaceable hydrogen attached to the carbocation. The third type is secondary, where we have 2 alkyl groups and 1 replaceable hydrogen attached to the carbocation, while the last type is called the tertiary carbonium ion. And this tertiary carbonium ion has no replaceable hydrogen attached to it. Now, the stability of this alkyl carbonium ion is a function of 2 of these 3 factors, and those are positive inductive effect as well as steric effect. Steric effect has to do with the bulkiness of the alkyl groups that are attached to the carbonium ion. But before we go to the stability proper, you need to understand that a carbonium ion is sp2 hybridized. Alkyl carbonium ion, to be precise, is sp2 hybridized. And because the hybridization of the carbon atom is sp2, the geometry of the molecule is trigonal planar, because this is sp2 hybridized. Now, the higher the number of alkyl groups attached to the carbonium ion, the more the stability, because the alkyl groups are electron releasing groups imposing positive inductive effect. So as they are releasing electron to the carbon atom, they increase the electron density on the carbonium ion, thereby making it to be more stable. Secondly, when there are more alkyl groups attached to the carbonium ion, the stability is higher due to steric effect. So those two factors favor the basicity, the stability of carbonium ions in that are obtainable from alkyl groups. So in order of increasing stability for alkyl carbonium ion, we have the methyl carbonium ion being the least stable because of absence of positive inductive effect and absence of steric effect, followed by primary carbonium ion, which is less stable compared to secondary carbonium ion, which is less stable compared to tertiary carbonium ion. So in a nutshell, the most stable alkyl carbonium ion is tertiary carbonium ion, while methyl carbonium ion is the least stable. And the factors that are responsible for this order of arrangement are positive inductive effect and steric effect. The second class are the allylic carbonium ions. Allylic carbonium ion is a carbocation that is attached to an olefinic carbon, where you have something of this nature. C, then you have CH double bond CH2. It's not necessary that this might be hydrogen, it might be another group. But as long as this carbon is attached here, the carbon atom here is called an allylic carbonium ion. And that can also be primary, secondary, or tertiary in nature. Let me give you an instance. If you have something like this, CH2, CH double bond, CH2. This is a primary allylic carbonium ion. Then if you have RCH, positive charge, CH double bond, CH2. This is a secondary allylic carbonium ion because the carbonium ion has one replaceable hydrogen. Then when you have R2C, CH double bond, CH2, with positive charge on this carbon, this is a tertiary carbonium ion. So in order of increasing stability, it follows the order of alkyl carbonium ions. So in that case, this is the most stable, the first rank, followed by this, why this is the least stable. So the order of arrangement is decreasing order of stability. Now, when you compare the stability of alkyl carbonium ion and that of allylic carbonium ion, allylic carbonium ions are more stable than alkyl carbonium ion. Why? Because of a factor that is called resonance effect. In allylic carbonium ion, there is possibility of resonance, whereby this pi electron can move here while the positive charge comes on this carbon. You now have something like this, double bond CH, then you have CH2 plus. So this is resonance. And the more the number of canonical structures that are obtainable from a compound or an intermediate, the more stable the intermediate or compound. So as a result of that, even primary allylic carbonium ion is more stable than tertiary alkyl carbonium ion because the resonance effect here supersedes both positive and steric effect respectively. The third type or class is what we call the benzylic carbonium ions. Just like benzylic carbon, a benzylic carbonium ion is a carbonium ion that is attached to a benzene ring. So we also have it in three types. This is primary because the carbon atom, the carbocation, has two replaceable hydrogen. This is secondary, R plus, why this is tertiary in nature, Cr2 plus, tertiary. So in this, the tertiary is still more stable, is still the most stable, while the primary is the least stable, based on positive inductive effect and resonance effect. However, the higher the number of aryl groups attached to the benzylic carbon, the more stable the carbon atom is. So in that case, consider the stability of this. Let us look at this
When you have something of this nature, you have CH3, 2 plus. Then you have something like this, CH, then you have, you can see, okay, this is secondary, this is tertiary, okay, then you have, you have something like this. This is also tertiary in nature because there are three aryl groups of benzene ring that are attached to that. So when you consider the stability of this, this is the most stable, followed by this, why this is the least stable. Despite that it's a tertiary carbonium ion, it is less stable compared to this because this is more favored by resonance compared to this one. So in that case, the more the number of benzene rings attached to the carbonium ion of benzenic carbon, the more stable it is. Then don't forget, benzenic carbon atoms are more stable than a lilic carbon because in benzenic carbon, you can obtain more canonical structures. Look at this. Okay, this pi electron can move here to give us another canonical structure. Okay, you have a positive charge here, double bond CH2. Then the pi electron can also move here to give us another canonical structure. Then you have a positive charge here, double bond, CH2. This pi electron can move here to give us another canonical structure. So that means a benzenic carbon will give you at least, okay, CH2, no double bond here, double bond. Then you have double bond, positive charge. We give you at least one, two, three canonical structures compared to two canonical structures obtainable from a lilic carbon. So the most stable of all is a benzenic carbon, be it primary, secondary, or tertiary. And tertiary of any type of carbocation is the most stable, irrespective of whether it is alkyl, allylic, or benzylic. So when you are given certain classes or different kinds of carbonium ion, classify them into allylic, benzylic, and alkyl before you now arrange based on the number of groups that are attached to the carbonium ion. You can also have acetylenic carbonium ion. Whereby the carbonium ion is obtained from an sp hybridized carbon. However, another factor that affects the stability of carbonium ion is hybridization of carbon. The higher the percentage s character, the lower the stability. So in that case, if you look at this, or the more the stability, but this is less stable compared to what you have in both allylic as well as benzylic. With this, you are expected to be able to arrange different kinds of carbonium ions in order of increasing or decreasing stability, and you must be able to justify your order of arrangement by stating the factors that are responsible for the order of arrangement. With this, you don't have any problem as regards carbonium ion. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to like, comment, and share the video, and as well subscribe to our YouTube channel. In our next episode, we are going to look at another type of organic reagents and their relative stability as we compare for carbonium ion. Thanks for watching. Remember to stay safe.